Welcome to Healthy Living. I'm Lorie Johnson. Thanks for tuning in. Today, we're talking about ways to stay safe this holiday season. Obviously, we need to take precautions against COVID-19. Sadly, cases are surging across the nation, so health experts advise wearing masks, social distancing, and avoiding crowds. But aside from health safety, we need to also be safe when it comes to predators who want to take advantage, particularly during the holidays when people are spending lots of money. Our guest today is Rania Mankarious, CEO of Houston Crime Stoppers, one of the nation's largest and most successful crime prevention organizations. Rania, great to see you again. Thanks for being here. So good to talk to you today.
Thank you so much for having me, Lorie. I always enjoy this time with you.
Well, this is a different holiday season. How has the pandemic changed the way people are buying holiday gifts?
It's changed the way we do everything, and especially shopping this holiday season. Most of us have been safe at home, some say stuck at home, but safe at home, trying to make sure that we are staying clear of this pandemic. Some of us have experienced tremendous loss, whether in loved ones or jobs or livelihood, but we want to connect during the holiday season. And a way we do that is to shop and buy gifts for each other and send them to one another. And we are seeing record spikes in online shopping. Just this last, you know, Black Friday alone, we saw around $11 billion spent in online retail shopping. We're up double-digit percentages from last year. And that's because we want to say, look, I'm thinking of you. I hope you're thinking of me. We want to replace some of the sadness with joy. We may not have a lot of finances to do this, which is why we're urging people to, of course, go online and shop. It's a wonderful way to still connect, but we need to be careful because online scammers know that that's where we're going to connect this holiday season, and they're looking to take your identity and your funds.
So criminals certainly are aware more people are buying things online, and people who might not used to be shopping online in this way. You know, in other words, many people who typically shop in person might be buying things online for the first time this Christmas season. So can you share with us some key points on how to purchase things online safely without getting ripped off or getting your identity stolen?
Absolutely. Look, we start by saying have an online shopping plan. Believe it or not, you need to be focused when you go online. Know who you're shopping for, what you're looking for. And the reason we say that is we don't want you to get distracted by all the little things, all the bells and whistles that you're going to see when you're online shopping. Know that scammers are out there. This is huge. You know, a lot of people are not thinking. You're thinking we're in a pandemic. We're all doing the best we can. Surely no one's going to be out there trying to take advantage of me at a time like this. But scammers are absolutely looking to take advantage of you in a time like this. So know what the scams look like, that they can come in through a fake website that looks real, through emails, through text messages. There's so many different ways that they're trying to reach out for you. So try to go to legitimate sites, places that have brick and mortar shops, websites that are secure. Look for that S at the end of the link at the beginning of the website to indicate that it's secure. Try to look for ratings. Make sure you're on a site that many have shopped on, that has a brand that's been there for a long time. Use a credit card, not a debit card, and then check those statements regularly. And if you see something looks odd, report it. Take records, take copies of everything and report it. And here's the thing, talk to everybody in the family who may be shopping online. It's odd to say this, but there are kids as young as 12, 13, up to the millennials in the home that are just online shopping. That group is not thinking about scams. They're not thinking of online safety. And we need to make sure that they start thinking about it, that before they put their name in, the credit card name, the credit card number, your address, that you've walked them through where they can do that and where they simply can't, or what the parameters are around their online shopping.
That is such great information. And you really brought up a great point about the different ages in your families who are shopping online, because some of the older people are opposite of the younger millennials who trust everyone. And some of the older people are really afraid to buy anything online because they think someone will steal their credit card information, even from reliable places like you were saying, you know, Macy's or somewhere. Talk about that little S again and how people can feel secure to buy online if this is their first time ever doing so.
You know, what we say is start at the basics. Go to the actual website. Start at a fresh screen from your computer. So let's take Macy's. If you get an email from Macy's that says, click here to get 30% off this holiday season, well, that's great. But don't click on the link. What we want you to do is shut everything. Go to Macy's.com, the actual website for the company. Make sure you see that S before that semicolon, backslash, and then the company name. Because that S says you're on a secured website, a verified website through the computer, through your social media, through your online platforms. And then you want to start there to do your shopping. There's a reason we say don't start with an email, because sometimes those emails are not even real. They're phishing emails. They look like an email from a reputable company, but what a scammer's done is they've stolen a logo, and when you click on that link, it's going to take you to another company altogether. So start at the original from a clean slate, and know that when you're on those secured websites, you can enter your credit card number in safely. I'm still going to say use a credit card, not a debit card, because the security, the safety features of a credit card surpass those of the debit card. But once you're on that secure site, don't be afraid to shop. You are safe to do so. But check your statements. Make sure your packages are delivered. You got everything that you said that you tried to purchase, and be on top of it. But it's safe to do it. Many of us do it every day.
You were saying that credit cards are better than debit cards from a security standpoint. What about when you're shopping in person? For example, let's say you're buying gasoline and you have a credit card and a debit card. Is there any difference there from a security standpoint?
So unfortunately, across the country, we're seeing that even, you go to get gasoline and there are little skimmers placed on the boxes where you put in your credit card to purchase your gasoline. What we want you to do is wherever you're going to share that information, whether you're physically inserting it or you're entering it online, to stick to a credit card, because credit card companies are insured. They have metrics in place to protect you. You're always going to want to check your balance sheet, your statement within the 30-day time frame. But even if you step outside that a little bit, a credit card company is going to be there to protect your losses and to help fight the claim. With a debit card, money is being removed directly from your account. And if it gets a little later, if you go past that 30 days, it's harder to dispute it. So as a rule of thumb, wherever you're going to insert that plastic or copy that number, try to use a credit card, because it just adds another layer of protection. Unfortunately, Lori, in today's world, these scammers have gotten so savvy, and they're at every point of payment, wherever we're going to pay, they've found a way to get there as well and capture information. So using a credit card just adds that other layer of protection.
Well, in my family, we ask each other what we want for Christmas, and a lot of times the younger people will just send us links. So if someone sends you a link to something they want, should you click on that link and buy it that way? Is that safe?
Well, you sound like you're talking about my own family. And in Santa this year, literally, the girls sent links, like a Google document with all the links of the things that they want. But I've had, let's go back to my original point. I've talked to my own children about safe shopping, and I've told them, before you send me a link, and I appreciate the link, and I think that's a great way to buy Christmas presents or holiday presents this year, make sure you yourself are on a reputable company. I put the onus on my own children. I want to make sure that you're on an actual company website. Do they have a brick and mortar? Do they have reviews? How long have they been in business? Show me that the website is secure. What do you need to look for to show me that the website is secure? And at this point, they've done their due diligence before they even send me the link. Now, when I get the link, I still check it. I go on, I do click, I see what they're looking for, what they're asking for. I see if I can find it less expensive anywhere else. I make sure that all those websites are actually verified and real. But it's important that all of us at all points are doing that due diligence, because these scammers have gotten so sophisticated. The number of fake websites that exist is just alarming, that it's important that all of us are being safety-minded when we do our online shopping. And that's a conversation I have, as I said, even with the young ones in the house.
Since so many people are buying online, a record number of packages will be sent this year. How do we protect ourselves from these so-called porch pirates?
Isn't it unbelievable that this is something we really have to worry about? So this pandemic has created the perfect storm for these porch pirates. One, we're all doing our online shopping. Two, as a culture, we've changed in terms of how we think of online shopping. Maybe a year ago, 2 years ago, we didn't want to make high-end purchases online, but now we're feeling more comfortable. It's also sometimes the only way to get these items. And then we're kind of letting things come as they come. Things are delayed. We're just happy to get them when they arrive. Porch pirates are literally aware of this, and they are driving around neighborhoods looking for packages that are at a front step, a front porch, and very carefully, nonchalantly, they're parking their car, walking up to a front door, taking a package, and they're on their way. When you consider the record number of shopping that we're doing online and the record number of home deliveries, it makes, again, it's a perfect time for this type of crime to take place. So what we're telling people to do is this. One, we're not telling you not to shop online, but we are saying, think about when things will be delivered. Try to align delivery at a time when you or somebody else is home, or arrange delivery to take place at your place of business, maybe at a parent's house or a neighbor's house. And home security is a big thing. If you can install a Ring camera or even signage that says that your home is being watched and monitored. Some people are able to install a lockbox at their front lawn, something that the mail carrier has access to, a key to, and that can accept packages, or they're doing P.O. boxes or taking advantages of the Amazon Hub delivery. There's many different things you can do. One of the last things I'll say is your online companies know that these porch pirates exist, and they're getting away with a record number of packages. So they're working with you. They're saying, look, do you want us to drop this off at the back door? Let us know if we can gain entry there. You can go online with Amazon and other companies and say, look, deliver this to the back or hide it in shrubbery. And Lorie, this happened to me the other day. I had a delivery come to the house. I ask for notification now. I ask for a text message to be sent to me when the item's delivered, and I'm sitting in my home office. I got the text message. I went out front. I couldn't find the package. The delivery company had put it securely behind some shrubs in our front yard, and I really appreciated that. So companies are working together with shoppers to ensure that packages can be delivered safely, because we know that this is happening and it's on the rise across the country.
Well, a lot of people like to take matters into their own hands, and they want to booby trap their yards. So is that something that you advise?
No, you can't do that. And believe it or not, I get asked this all the time. And it's frustrating, because these scammers, you'll see them dressed up as delivery men, or delivery women. They'll be in Amazon shirts, and they'll be walking with a box. They'll drop it off at your house. It's fake. And then they'll pick up your box. And it's so frustrating, because, you know, people will say, well, it's not fair. I want to be able to do something to protect my property. Unfortunately, booby trapping or setting up your own fake box. We had some people say, I'm going to put some type of loud firecracker inside, so when they pick up the box, it sort of makes an explosive sound, but it doesn't really hurt them. You can't do it. If the scammer, the criminal, gets injured, suffers a heart attack, gets hurt in any way, you as a property owner can face civil or criminal liability. So what we say instead is put the signage up, take all the steps we talked about to protect yourself proactively. But you can't go as far as trying to defend your property by booby trapping it or setting up any of these fake packages. You can put an empty box, maybe fill it with a rock or two, but you can't do anything that will scare them or frighten them, because you will face liability.
So while many more people than ever are buying Christmas presents online, there are still plenty of us who are going to the malls and other in-person stores. Can you address some of the issues to ensure that in-person shopping is productive, safe, and, of course, fun?
Absolutely. Look, you and me and every woman across this country longs to do some of that, you know, walking around the mall with your favorite coffee or your friend and just doing some shopping. And we hope to get back to that. And some of us can still do that in limited numbers. But we want us to be public safety minded as we do it. Unfortunately, the culture of crime is changing across this country. We're seeing cities, major cities, run by municipalities that are seeing crime differently. They're not responding to it the way we did a few years ago. Law enforcement themselves are finding that they can't respond to criminal behavior and activity the way we want them to as citizens. It's just the culture's changing. That means that criminals know this and they're committing brazen criminal activity in daylight, you know, while you're just doing your holiday shopping. So think about that. Don't be scared. We still want you to go out. We still want you to have a fun time, but think about what you're carrying. I'm a mom of three. I can't tell you how many times I go out shopping and I look at my bag and I say, why do I have this huge tote with me that not just has, you know, vital records that shouldn't be in my bag? I one day I noticed I had extra jewelry. I had my daughter's passport in the bag because I was planning to run errands a different day. So stop and empty all that out. Carry just what you need. We talked about having an online shopping plan. Have a physical shopping plan. Know what stores you're going to. Map it out. Start at the farthest. Work your way down to the closest to your car. Don't do drop-offs during your shopping day where you go and put bags in your car and then go back out to the mall. If somebody's watching you, they're going to be jumping on that opportunity to steal from your car the second you walk away. It's not bad to ask the mall or the store to walk out with you. Once you're done and you're ready to leave, have security walk with you to your car just so you can take your time and put everything in your vehicle safely. And be cognizant. Know where you park. Know what time of day. You know, if you're going to be walking out at night, are you parked in a place you feel safe to walk out to at night? There's just a lot of different things. And Lori, we always say being public safety minded is not about being paranoid. It's just thinking in a healthy way. We think about this with our skin and anti-aging and how we eat food. It's great. So think about it when you're online, when you're out and about doing your errands. There's nothing wrong with it. It's not about scaring you. It's about making sure you go and come and have the best day you can possibly have.
You know, Crime Stoppers is all about safety online, and not just safety surrounding purchasing gifts online, but communicating with others through social media and other platforms. Again, so many people are new to this because of the pandemic and aren't aware of the dangers involved. Let's talk about those super popular Zoom calls. Can you tell us about these so-called Zoom bombings and how to stay clear of them?
Well, it's horrific, actually, and we were victims of it not too long ago. And what it means is somebody takes hold of your meeting ID and password, and they infiltrate your Zoom session, and they take over, and they can do anything. And I'll tell you, when we endured it, it was horrific in terms of the language that they used and the images that they showed. So as we're pushing for the country to get together virtually this holiday season, many people are setting up Zoom family meetings. Make the meetings private, make them password protected, and don't share any of that information on social media. Make sure the host sets up a waiting room and only lets in people that he or she knows, that you have the ability to mute or end the call at any time. These are really, really important because, unfortunately, while we're just trying to gather and survive, there are young kids that aren't, this isn't about a scam, but they think it's funny to infiltrate and really take over a very special time. So it's important that people know about this.
So for those rare in-person gatherings, what's your advice?
Follow your local guidelines. And every city and state's going to be different, but if it's required that you no more than 10 gather, be cognizant of that. If you're able to do so outside, do that. In terms of how you serve food, think about the setup and how many serving spoons are used and who has access to them. Maybe one person can serve for the table. Have sanitary items around, Purell and other wipes available for your guests at all time. You know, we don't want to not gather, but if we do gather, let's make sure we're following guidelines and we're doing it safely.
Rania, after many months of COVID, a great deal of our country is hurting mentally, physically, and emotionally. Can you explain ways to give back safely?
Yeah, I think it's important that we do this. And I'll start by saying we know that many adults are hurting mentally and emotionally. Make sure you have the conversations with your children about how they feel, considering traditions have changed, and then use that for good. Talk about volunteering in your community, where you can use technology to reach out to people who might be alone, how you can mail gifts to maybe your elderly parents, people that you won't be able to visit to. There are many families in need. Anything from a letter, an email, an e-card, to gifts, meals, etc. There's so much that can be done. And bring the kids in the home into it. Let them share their feelings. Let them be part of the solution. Create a new family tradition that lives on with your family. And it's a wonderful way to explain how we're all in this together. I think this is one of, you know, in a very difficult time, there are silver linings, and there's a lot of beauty that has come out of these difficult days, weeks, and months. And I think kids need to be pulled into that as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, unfortunately, we're out of time. Rania, can you tell our viewers how they can learn more about you?
Well, I'd love to connect with your viewers. They can follow me on Instagram at The Rania Report. I have a website, raniamankarious.com, and certainly we are constantly pouring information out to the community through our organizational website, crime-stoppers.org.
All right, well, that'll do it for this edition of Healthy Living. Thank you so much, Rania Mankarious, for being with us. Great to see you again, as always.
Thank you so much. Great to see you, Lorie.